Alright guys, some of you asked for a video of to see my LMI 392 true cold air intake installed on my car, and here it is. Took some time cutting. I used a Dremel and didn't want to use a hole saw because I didn't have time to sit there and actually make a guide for it. I just wanted to hurry up and get it done. So Dremel tool. Didn't take very long. It was actually pretty easy. Just had to grind it down and then resize it once I put in that protector thing that goes around the edge. Basically, it's like a door frame protector for not bumping other cars. Anyways, I haven't installed water methanol injection yet, so I just connected the two until later. Plan on going to Dito's Motors in South San Francisco to have him install it. I think he quoted me at about $750 to $800, and that's using Snow Performance Stage 3. Anyways, yeah, I know it's not exactly the prettiest thing in the world because I've got these up on top rather than down below, but I mean, as far as that goes, I don't care. I mean, they look good right now, and whenever I take it to a show, maybe I'll turn it around. But honestly, I don't really care. You know, it works, it's easy to get to, and it's easy to work on, so tough rock, guys. And for those of you that knew about my stainless steel hose problem, basically it was a vacuum leak. I got some stuff from Speed Logics, and apparently the whole spool of stainless steel was bad. So what happens is when it collapses in on itself and it causes a vacuum leak, your car will go into a high idle, somewhere around 3,000 to 4,000 RPMs. So yeah, you can peel out in the middle of a dead stop or whatever, and you have to hold the brake and shut off the engine. Anyways, that's it. Hope you enjoyed. Subscribe.